Good morning, Minnesota! And good morning, late debaters. I'm Jack Tomczak.
I'm Benjamin Cruzzi.
You hit me in the face with the microphone.
And I hit him in the face with the microphone. We've got a show on AM 1130 called The Late Debate. We're on right after Jason Lewis, 8 to 10, Monday through Friday. And if you're not listening, you are missing out. I'd like to thank everybody for coming to the tax rally today. You could be home raking leaves, cleaning out the garage, or washing windows, but you chose to sacrifice and come out here and hang out with what will be thousands of like-minded individuals. Or you're homeless. Either way, I'm glad you're here.
Yeah, but he's got a chair.
You've got a chair, it can't be that bad. All right, we're gonna have some speakers in the first hour and 45 minutes here, and some music by Cousin Billy and Cousin Dan. Our first speaker, good.
Now there is a strict 1 minute rule on these speeches, so we will be very quick with the hook. So we got that 1 minute, you got it?
Unless we need to fill time. All right, the first group, we've got Tammy Houle. She's the chair of the Constitution Party of Minnesota, and Tim Oost, who is the chair of CD5 for the Constitution Party. Come on up.
Good morning, good afternoon. It's a pleasure to be here. For those of you that are tired of the status quo that is enslaving us under this burdensome, escalating taxation, the status quo needs an alternative. The Constitution Party is that alternative. For you homeless people without a party to represent you, we're right down there. Come and sign up. Come to our convention next Saturday, Edina Public Library.
Hi, everybody. That was a really weak introduction for you guys, but here we go. Thank you all. Thank you. I want to just say one thing. We have a state constitution. Right behind us here, these people ignore it because we let them. We got, is it, who has read the state constitution? We got a few, maybe 10 or 15 out of 300. Shame on us, because until we read it and hold these guys accountable, they're gonna do whatever they wanna do. So it's up to us to stand up and start holding these people behind us accountable. Thanks a lot, guys, enjoy the day.
Thanks, Tim.
64 seconds, excellent work.
Tim, is this the, Tim? Tim Oots? Tim?
Tim!
Tim, is this the living, breathing Constitution?
No!
I kid!
No.
I kid! I kid! Alright. I'd like to introduce Cousin Billy and Cousin Dan.
Alright!
Hi, everybody. How are you doing today?
Thank you. Very much.
We're Cousin Billy, Cousin Dan. We're rocking and rolling a little bit. We're going to do some original music. All pro American.
Yeah.
All right, you guys.
This next song we're doing is written kind of in an old style, which I think we'll all like. It's called Old Time in Music. It starts out with a bass guitar, goes like this.
That guy raised his hand before.
That guy, the homeless guy. How many beer drinkers we have in the crowd? Yay! How many people who buy things are in the crowd? Well, your taxes are going up, congratulations. There is good news though, there is good news. You're all rich, according to the DFL, congratulations. Our next speakers come to us from Liberty, Minnesota. We've got Dave Wallstead and Mark Wegscheid. Come on up, fellas. Thank you. Thanks for all coming out on this beautiful day. We're from Liberty, Minnesota. You can find us right over there in the front corner with a big Liberty, Minnesota sign. And we're the ones flying the drone around. So who is Liberty, Minnesota? Liberty, Minnesota. We're dedicated to the principles of liberty and committed to winning. Not just winning a few battles, but to really winning the war. Here's Dave.
Thanks. Our goal is to inspire the grassroots to come out, elect a new wave of leaders that's finally going to change things and move us back towards a peaceful, voluntary, civilized society for the first time in our history. Our goal is to provide hope to people who know that things have been messed up for too long, going the wrong direction for too long, don't see how to change it. We're going to be coming out with a lot of initiatives that should give people hope and give them something to do that they feel like can bring their country back. So hope you'll join us. Stop at that booth right there in the first tent, and we'll see you there. Thanks.
All right, we know we got Mother's Day coming up, but my cousin and I wrote a song called Daddy We're Gonna Do, and I like it. I hope you do too. Little boy slips and he scrapes his knee. Daddy, will you come and help me? Hey, Dad, you know it's almost free. Daddy, will you come and help me? Oh, Father's Day, Dad. My son's out there somewhere. Where are you, kid? Okay, this next one we're going to do is called America. America. I'm gonna make it.
also a QR code.
Oh, okay.
Come on.
Okay.
Finally.
Yeah.
And how many of you folks took a train to get here? And no one. Okay, just checking. All right, our next speaker is Steve Rogers with Pistol Craft. Come on up, Steve. Thanks, Jack. So, thanks for coming out, everybody. I'm Steve Rogers. I'm with Pistol Craft. We're a training firm. We do a lot of carry permits, a lot of self-defense. We approach from a perspective of awareness and avoidance or self-defense, and that the use of firearms is a unfortunate necessity, so we train in combat-proven skills. We like to try to get everybody to think of this as something where you want to stay alive and out of prison, not just get a carry permit. So come and visit our booth. We're over on the right, three down from the top. Have a great day and enjoy the weather. We've earned it. Thanks, Steve.
All right. The Minnesota House just passed this week an omnibus tax bill that raises your taxes by $3 billion when all the taxes and fees are added up. $3 billion. That's an extra $527 for every man, woman, and child in the state of Minnesota. So if you're a family of four, do you got an extra $2,000 lying around? Because, you know, I could use that. Now, if you're angry, Minnesota majority has set up an action center right over to our right, to your left. I don't know if that's stage left or stage right. Jack is the theater major in the group. But you can send from one of these computers a message that gets sent to, you put in your address, it gets sent to your House of Representatives member, your senator, and the governor. It gets sent, and trust me, these legislative assistants, when they get your phone calls, when they get your emails, when they get your letters, they are listening. They have to listen. And you got to start giving them that. So come over here to my right to sign up at the Action Center for Minnesota Majority. And if you have one of these yellow flyers, there's a QR code. You can take a picture of it with your phone and actually send a message to your legislators and the governor from your phone. So go over there, do something, fix this. And now,
All right, and now, Will Hageman with the National Coalition for Men. What up, Will?
Good morning. I'm with the National Coalition for Men. NCFM raises awareness of discrimination against men and discrimination against boys. This includes men's lives being ruined by false accusations of rape or domestic violence, family court bias against men, fathers being pushed out of their children's lives, abuse of restraining orders, and domestic violence against men. Come visit us. We're over on the west side here, one of the blue canopies. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Will. Next, we've got Charlotte with the Minnesota Objectivist Association. Come on up.
If we want to change the world, it has to be through ideas, because that is what has got us into this mess. So Ayn Rand's ideas, which is based on reason and reality, is the way to do it. If you want more information, come back to our booth. We've got lots of stuff for free. And then we also are having a drawing at 1 o'clock for some free books. Thanks.
All right, thanks, Charlotte.
Yeah, we're ready.
Cousins, you ready?
Yeah, we're ready.
You ever to sing along?
Sure.
No, you don't.
Yeah,
no, you don't.
You on the radio?
Well, that's a talking job.
Oh, is that okay?
You can sing. Have you heard me sing? Don't worry about it.
This next one we're going to do is called Election Day. Times are bad, and that ain't good. If your man only makes half what he should, he makes 50 hours so he don't get the pay. New economy's in his way. Grandpa served and his daddy did too. He was taught really young, that's what you gotta do. Paying his taxes and his seat things through. Now he's stuck, he don't know what to do. He had a trade to a farm, an army discharge. He was working hard, but he was living hard. High school sweetheart was a hell of a girl. He was happy to brought those kids in the world. Never should have thought it would work out that way. $100 for an honest day.
felt that way. She heard an honest dollar for an honest day. The imports came and took it all away. Stands there short with no money to pay. Oh yeah.
Give her a nice round of applause.
Thank you. Good morning. Thank you all for coming out. I am with the Republican Liberty Caucus. We're a national organization. We believe in individual rights, constitutionally limited government, and free markets. Our booth is on the west side of the mall here. But I really want to thank you for coming out because we are kind of ahead of the game. This is about taxpayer freedom. A government that pays for your things gets to control them. So, yeah, healthcare, that's great, but a government that pays for your healthcare can control your medicine. A government that pays for your transportation can control how you move. So, thank you all for being here. It is about freedom, and have a great day.
And now we get to fill time. How many of you have a high school diploma?
I do.
Pat yourself on the back. It now means nothing.
What?
DFL wants to get rid of graduation standards.
Both the House and Senate voted for that.
Now, when the governor came out and said that he wanted a 100% graduation rate, we thought that was ridiculous.
It's impossible.
It's
not possible.
But good for him for setting a high goal.
He achieved it.
We didn't know that getting rid of having to know or do anything to get a diploma or to graduate would be part of that plan. Now it makes sense. I guess my last joke.
See a guy over here. I'm done. I'm moving to Wisconsin. Are you? Do you have room on your truck? I got some stuff that I should bring over there.
We had a guy on the late debate. What? Wednesday? Thursday?
This week? Yep. He wrote a book called
How Money Walks. Now, we had thought, as people who've been involved in politics for a while, big-time regional celebrities, that oftentimes people threaten Well, if things don't get better, I'm going to move. If they don't lower taxes, I'm going to move. You watch this, DFL. Businesses are going to leave. So this guy comes in. His name is Travis Brown. Wrote the book, How Money Walks. People are already doing it without threatening.
People have been doing it for the last decade. And so you might enjoy this weather out here, this beautiful 70-degree, clear, sunny spring day. First one in what, like
seven years, I think. Yeah.
But guess what? Florida, Arizona, Texas, they got this weather all the time. And they're not taking your money.
I'd like to recognize one person in the crowd.
Just one.
Just one. We got Randy Gilbert. Randy, raise your hand, Randy Gilbert.
Hi, Randy.
Randy is running for state auditor. We had another announcement this week that Scott Honor is running for governor. I think it's great that people are getting out in front of this and willing to step up and replace the current DFL folks in office. Now, we had last night on the late debate, which you guys should listen to every Monday through Friday from 8 to 10 p.m., Two-Putt Tommy.
He's a liberal blogger.
Hated liberal blogger.
Hated. We brought him on so that he could defend all these taxes that this state capitol is going to make you pay, make you defend every vote that Democrats are taking, all these ridiculous rules and
laws. We brought him in to have a DFLer we could rough up a little bit. Show them our anger at what they were doing, the tax increases they were proposing and passing.
You know what he said? He said they're overreaching. He said they've gone too far.
The guy sounded like he was running for chair of the Republican Party. Even DFLers think this is too much.
Democrats realize how bad it's getting in here. And hopefully voters do too. So if any of you have friends that go, yeah, you know what? I think the rich should pay more. Let them know that this House and this Senate have voted or are going to vote, not to raise taxes on the top 2% like they said when they were getting elected. That's what they got elected for. But they're raising taxes on everybody. If you're a family and you file your taxes and you make $33,000 a year, you used to be in the lowest tax bracket in this state. The House of Representatives just passed a law that would put you into the second tax bracket from 5.5% to 7%. They raised your taxes if you make only $33,000 a year as a married couple. Everyone's taxes are getting raised. Don't believe the 2% crap.
But didn't they campaign on that? Didn't Mark Dayton, when he ran for governor,
he said,
at the DFL House, I'm going to raise taxes on everybody.
The middle class is safe, he said.
He did.
He said the poor are safe. It's only going to be the top 2%. And what do we get from the Minnesota Senate? We're going to raise taxes on the top 7%.
Did anybody here vote for Mark Dayton?
Oh.
All right, I got one back
one
there.
One guy, very brave, sir. Looking for.
You're forgiven, and I told you so. Alright, we're gonna go find some more folks to do their minute. Pipe in some music. Music pipers.
We'll be starting with the speeches in just a bit, but thank you for coming out and have a wonderful morning.
Hey guys, we were Cousin Billy, Cousin Dan. We just wanted to let you know we got a booth with CDs and Don't Tread On Me flags right at the end of the quarter, right on the street. So stop by and say hi to us. And thank you very much, and God bless everybody.
That was not bad. Businesses, that's every dealership.
Every dealership. Every dealership.
Yep.
All the people that are actually going to help us win our election.
Oh, I get it. I get it. I'm supposed to step back.
That's how our candidates are really too.
He threw him in the trash right in front of us. Please let him. Nope, not kidding you. I was saying threw the trash right in front of
us. Oh, it's over there, right there.
Probably grab one. All
right. Right at the tail end of two of them. Go any higher?
Go any higher. Do
you know that you're sitting here? I think you need to sit in the lobby. Sort of found out. If you want to take this,
If you needed it, you say, I don't care.
Do you have any questions? Do you really want to bring the constituency
to me? That's not what we're here for. I think until people want to say, you want to pay out in tax payers.
There's one.
It's not synonymous with it, it's just like clean expertise.
Thanks so much, God bless you today.
And so,
thank you, Doc. You're joining us next week, Ryan is in passing with the Minnesota College Republicans.
So they don't want you in
Dallas. Hello, and young people.
Thanks for having me come on, guys. What a beautiful day to stand for government accountability. My name is Andrew Hasek. I'm the newly elected chairman of Minnesota College Republicans, and I'm joined here with my sister, who's the executive director of College Republicans, Angie Hasek, as well. And college students, we've been keeping an eye on what's been sent through the Minnesota House this week. All the tax increases ranging from clothing to tattoos and to my least favorite, and one that's not very popular among college students, and that's increased taxes on beer. But my goal as chairman of Minnesota College Republicans is to build an organization that is going to be extremely effective here coming up in the next 2013 and 2014 and put the boots on the ground that we need to take some of these tax-friendly politicians out of office. And so hopefully you'll stand with me, check out our booth in the back, but I hope you have a great day, enjoy all the great speakers. Thanks for coming out, guys.
Crockett with the center of the American experiment. Come on up, Kim. The book we were talking about earlier came into town for the center, and Kim got him on the show. It's a great organization. Give it up for Kim Crockett.
Thanks, Jack. Good morning, I'm Kim Crockett. Thanks for coming out on this gorgeous day. American Experiment is a powerful think tank here in the state of Minnesota. We have the intellectual firepower to push back on bad policies, on spending, taxes, and other bad ideas. And then what we do with our studies and so forth is we get them to the folks back here, because they actually believe that if you spend more and tax more, we will have a culture of prosperity here in Minnesota. We know better at the center. We know that that's not what builds a culture of prosperity. Now, I was getting my hair cut a couple weeks ago, and I said, well, we've just come out with this study on spending in Minnesota and how it's harming the state. And my hair cutter Connie at Fantastic Sam said to me, Kim, why'd you need a study? I could have told you that myself. And I said, well, believe it or not, we actually do have to produce these things. So if you're interested in seeing our reports, we're back here at the table down the way. And just finally, I just want to let you know, I'm born and bred Minnesotan, and I plan to stay here and fight for our state. I want my kids to come to stay here during college, to come back. I want my grandkids here. They're pushing us out, folks, and we can't let them. So thanks for being here today. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Kim. Joining us next is another joke by me.
Oh!
Ooh, let him.
They took the drum kit. How will they know without a rim shot if you're being funny?
I have a plan. The bold, late debate tax reform plan. Taxes should be cut.
So brave.
And the money brought in by those cut taxes should go to legitimate government spending. Roads, not trains. Schools, not trains. But I'm not saying the government can't build trains and stadiums.
How will they pay for it?
Eat poll tax.
That'll work.
Anytime the government wants to spend money that isn't on a road, eat poll tax. And that's it. No backups. Eat poll tabs. All right, our next speaker. See, the joke there is that eat poll tabs don't bring in any money. Forget it.
I'm 8 out of 10 confident that that's true.
Joining us next from Reform Property Taxes, Rolf Erickson. Rolf, do you have immigrants in your background? Rolf Erickson?
Just a couple.
Just a few. Okay, there you are.
Two back.
Thank you. Reform Property Taxes is a nonprofit. We have a lobbyist who's been over, me like in Trent, who's been over at the Capitol. Every session of the Property Tax Committee. And it's very interesting because I believe there's one or two other lobbyists that I know of who are probably working for nothing that are actually representing the people. We pay with our taxes lobbyists to lobby against us from League of Cities, counties, other things to actually, mostly they're over there asking for more taxes. But we're a very simple organization, and our purpose is to educate people about property taxes, suggest alternatives, ways of spending less, doing things for more, and to lobby the elected officials. We're membership-based. We've got a little flyer, and we'd like to encourage anyone who wants to try to fight for the people and not for the government to join us. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I want to remind everybody that there is an action center to your left where you can go to a laptop and immediately send a message to your House member, to your Senate member, and to the governor that you're sick of this, that you want taxes not raised, taxes lowered. If you've got one of these yellow sheets, there's a little QR code here, this little box of checkered squares. You take a picture of that with your phone, it'll take you to a website. You can do this from your phone. So send a message to your House member, your Senate member, and the governor. Watch out, drone. Dude, they're watching you! You have rights!
Our next speaker comes from the Libertarian Party, the party that is right on everything. I'd like to encourage folks to attend their convention May 4th because Ben and I will be speaking there. Bob Odden, Libertarian Party.
Yeah, thank you. Well, people always ask me, what is a libertarian? A libertarian is somebody who believes in liberty. Liberty is the exercise of freedom that does not impinge upon the rights of others. And freedom is your ability to interact with others without government interference. Now, who in the hell could be for that? I mean, you know, we're electing people, we got people in this legislature that they don't believe in the individual. They don't want you to be an individual. They want to force you into groups. And they want to take away all your freedoms and your rights. They don't care how much of your money you spend because they feel that even if they break the state financially, that what they're doing is right.
Or actually,
yeah. We can't argue with them on the Constitution because they don't believe in it. So we have to find another way to get our point across. But join the Libertarian Party. Our convention again is this Saturday. The party's getting stronger and stronger all the time with Ron Paul people coming in. And I think you'll find a home. We look forward to seeing you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Here's the music sound, guys. Holden for mayor. He's running for mayor of St. Paul. Good luck. Good luck. Here we go. All right, Tim Holden, running for mayor of St. Paul.
People, how are we doing out there? Are we having a good time with the weather? Is this a beautiful day or what?
All right, well, let's fire up St. Paul. I'll tell you what, we need to get the capital city to act like the capital city. No more of this second nature seat. We need to do something downtown and fire people up. The crowd here today, we need to double this. We need to talk to people. We need to spread the word with everybody that's got the same ideas that we have, the same background, the same vision. People need to get united, and that's the bottom line. When we have core values like we do with cutting property taxes, holding the line on taxes, and using common sense, people need to start talking. I would say that for a day, you know, when it's 70 degrees, first day of the year, we deserve this. It's been a long winter, a long spring, and it's time that we fire up St. Paul. St. Paul needs a new leader. I'm a businessman myself, 15 years on University Avenue. Just a little bit of history. I've got a property that's at University and Snelling, and the new light rail has basically crushed us. The reason I'm up here, I'm a small business owner, is that I need to see change. The administrators that are up top right now, they don't listen, they don't care what's happening, and it's tragic. We need leaders that will listen to the people. The mayor now is going to build a new ballpark downtown St. Paul, and the people downtown St. Paul and Lower Town are irate. We're going to hold a press conference on Wednesday at 12 o'clock noon at the Farmer's Market. The farmer's market's been there for over 150 years, and the farmer's market could go bye-bye if they don't do some planning and get some common sense involved with this project. This ballpark is $58 million, not 54, it's 58, and it's your taxpayer dollars. So people need to fire up and talk to people about what's going on before it's too late. St. Paul, we need a leader. We need somebody downtown that's going to listen. We need to hold the line on taxes. And the bottom line is, people, you need to have a voice. So you got to fire everybody up that you know, get them involved. People need to be involved. I just want to say thanks for your time today, and everybody have a good day. Stop at our booth. Well done, and good luck, Tim.
Yes. All right, as a reminder that conservatives come from everywhere in Minnesota and everywhere in the world, we have a special guest, Omar Hassan. He's a Somaliland small business owner. Thanks for joining us.
Hello, everybody. Minnesota is here, and we are also here. The Somaliland people are very supportive, and they are doing the same values as you guys. We are glad to be joining you today. We will be with you all the time. We have the same values as you, and we are willing to get the same rights. We are fighting for the same values. Tax breaks are necessary for everybody. And as a business owner for more than 10 years here in Minneapolis, I like this kind of a voice. It's helping us, it's helping our people, and it's helping you, same like it's helping us. So thank you very much. And everybody, please cheer up, and we are with you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Hi. What's your name?
Good
job. Thank you.
I want to make everyone aware that the House of Representatives in this tax bill raised the tax on a pack of cigarettes. It was around 47 cents. They've raised it $1.60. $1.60. So more than doubled, more than tripled. If you are angry about that, there's a booth of the Citizens for Tobacco Rights. You can visit them at tobaccorights.com or go to their booth. They're along the left column here. So the Citizens for Tobacco Rights.
Next speaker is Scott Walker. He's with a group of Cambodian veterans. Come on up, Scott. We love Scott Walker. Yes.
A little closer if you can, gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen.
My name is Scott Walker. I'm the former chairman of the Republican Party here in St. Paul. I am more commonly referred to as the Gopher Scott Walker, not the Badger Scott Walker. So we're very much appreciative of having an opportunity to speak to you here today. I am working with the Americans commonly know as Cambodians, Cambodian veterans that served in the secret war in Cambodia, serving the United States, supporting and serving the United States military during the secret war of Cambodia and Laos. Our veterans here are survivors of that war, as well as many here are survivors of the Khmer Rouge, as you remember in the 1975 to 1979. Last year, I'm also involved with a group called the International Khmer Assembly, which are establishing chapters all over the world right now, uniting Cambodian communities in larger and smaller communities in Europe, United States, Canada, and the Pacific Coast nations. We're here representing our Chicago chapter for some training that we're going to be doing here this afternoon. Minnesota was made history in the Khmer community last year when the state legislature, both the Senate and the House, for the first time in history, formally recognized the Cambodian veteran for supporting U.S. forces and defending freedom and democracy in Southeast Asia. Our Chicago members who have traveled from Chicago today are in the process of training to get that resolution passed in the other state legislatures in the United States. So we're going to go to Illinois next, North Dakota. We have some strong veterans in North Dakota and all over the United States. And ultimately, we will attempt to get this resolution passed in the United States Congress, hopefully next year. So we can certainly use your support, and we will certainly want to recognize these proud survivors and veterans of the Vietnam conflict. So thank you so much for giving us the opportunity, and please come up and welcome our friends here. We'd like to meet you as well. So thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Scott.
Thank you for your service. A lot of folks out there that the DFL takes for granted and assumes they will be voting their way, and they're usually right. It is time, I'm glad we're doing it, working to make that less true. Joining us now is a man who might hate trains more than I do, Steve Ellenwood, the Senate District 53, BPOU, the Republican Party. Steve.
Hi there, I'm Vice Chair of Senate District 53, you know, vice, cigarettes, drinking, other various things, and now these buggers are going to tax us more. So SD53 is here because we want you to know we need and are looking for conservative people we can get elected in the Woodbury area, and we want to educate people in what these guys are doing to us. So one of the things we're doing is putting on a movie called Frack Nation. And if you'd like information on how and where to go see this, because it's all about the good things that our fracking is doing, not the bad as they're trying to tell us, please stop by our booth number 20 and we'll give you all the information that you could possibly want and not even know you need at our booth. Thank you.
Thanks, Steve.
What, the DFL?
Oh, okay, frack.
They're against fracking. All right, up next, Michael Cummins with the Concerned Veterans for America.
Hello.
Thanks, Michael.
Good morning, everyone. What a great day God has given us. We got to give him a big hand. Anyways, my name is Mike Cummins. I'm here with Concerned Veterans for America. What we are is we're a 501c4. We talk about purpose and policy. We do not talk about party or people. We are here today and asking for you, so I'm asking you to come over to our table. We are here today with a petition to remove General Shinseki from as Secretary of the VA. In 2009, when he was went into office, our backlog at the VA was 165,000 people. Right now, it's over 630, and we see a million on the horizon. 53 veterans die each day before their claims even get seen by the VA, and most of the claims are over 125 days. We are here today to ask you to join us and signing our petition to send to Concerned Veterans for America, and we're asking for his removal from as secretary. Please come by my table, sign our petition, and let's have a great day here at the tax rally. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, Michael. Up next, from the Legislative Evaluation Assembly of Minnesota, John Augustine. Hey,
Josh. Thanks, Jack. It's great weather. Crowd's building. Sounds good to me. All right, LEA is an all-volunteer, nonpartisan organization that publishes an annual report evaluating the Minnesota legislature and honoring the top scorers. Our annual member dues, it's all volunteer citizen driven, our annual member dues are only $10. If you stop by one of the nice vendors today and have a sandwich and drink, you've already spent more than that, and we can have a long lasting impact if you help support us. We need $10 annual member dues, contributions, and citizen efforts from all of you great people to help accomplish our mission, which is to inform citizens and evaluate the legislature on such principles as legal and moral order, constitutionalism, limited government, and free enterprise. Let's hear it for free enterprise. Yeah. All right. Have a great day, everyone.
Now,
yeah! You're on Instagram now. All right, I want to remind everybody that to our right, to your left, is a booth. I see a bunch of people filing in there now. There's a bunch of laptops in there. You put in your address, and it emails your state representative, your state senator, and the governor to tell them that what's happening this week with these tax bills is ridiculous, and that you want it different. And if you've got one of these yellow, that's a white flyer. There's the yellow flyer. There is a QR code at the bottom of this. If you take a photo of that with your QR reader on your smartphone, you can actually email your representative, your senator, and your governor all on your phone.
It's more goldenrod.
More goldenrod.
All right, next speaker is Patrick Monroe with FreedomPosse.us.
Hey, thanks.
All right, Patrick.
Hello, my name's Patrick Monroe. Thank you for allowing me to speak. Taxpayers League. I have some t-shirts down there for an organization. We're selling t-shirts to fund operations for FreedomPosse.us, which is a conservative activist organization. What we're going to do is we're going to bring the fight to the enemy. We're going to bring demonstrations, peaceful and respectful demonstrations, to the liberal media organizations that are enabling the destruction of our Republican democracy. So this is, if you want to help us out, we got t-shirts down there. You can go to the website, which is freedomposse.us, and sign up. We'll shoot you an email, let you know where we are demonstrating, and if you want to come and help us protest, get that critical mass going, we would appreciate it, because I think if we bring the fight to these organizations, we'll get them to back down, and hopefully we can start the deconstruction of this liberal mindset, statist mindset that has overtaken our state government and our federal government. On the back of my shirt is Remember Benghazi. When I was in Iraq, I did an economic analysis of the province of Karbala. Whenever we had a State Department official come to that facility there in Karbala, they were armed to the teeth.
okay? George Bush made sure that his people were taken care of and defended. So we need to get the truth out about how the Obama administration just abandoned those heroes out there and allowed them to be slaughtered by a bunch of Islamist, fascist Nazis, okay? And we can't allow that ever to happen again for anybody in our special ops communities to ever be abandoned like that. We need to have the full force of the United States military protecting all our personnel whenever possible. Right. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Patrick.
I might be alone in this, but let me ask you. Is it getting too hot? Alright, next is
spring.
Deanna Strauss, board member with Minnesota Voters Alliance. Deanna.
My name is Deanna Strauss, and I'm representing and a board member of Minnesota Voters Alliance. How many people like Mark Ritchie? Alright, we're taking sure that people are eligible before they vote. And we're saying, yes, you do. And that's what your job title says, basically. So he's telling the people one thing and the court another. We've caught him. So now we're taking him to task. And we're saying, you need to verify these people. Same-day registration can be repaired. It's not that we want to take it away. We don't want grandma not to vote. That's not the issue here. We want to make sure that grandma is eligible. That's what we do. So we got a table down there on the other side, and come visit us, sign up for our registration, and then just to be able to get a little information on what's happening and keep you posted. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Joining us next from the North Metro and East Metro Tea Party, Jake Duesenberg, and my second favorite, Jack Rogers.
Thank you very much, Jack. Jack, you got the script, so you start this thing out. Go ahead.
I got the script because he wrote it and said it just like this or I'm going to be really upset. But let's start with the North Metro Tea Party. Yes. What a great group. 8 coordinators over there can hardly keep up with the growth. We recently had to move to the Mermaid over in Moundsview because the Blue Fox got sold. So we had outgrown it, but we didn't outgrow the love of the owners over there. But on May 9th, we got our second chapter, and Michelle Bachman will be there. Yes. I walked around the grounds here, and there's one thing that's very important to understand. We are very individual, are individuals that think very, very carefully about things. But the most important thing we have to think about is the unity to not only win each of the upcoming elections in the next couple years, but to destroy the DFL and their socialism. You do that not by being divisive within our own groups, but by finding advantages we can work together in. I had a great chance to work with Jake in starting his party, and he's going to tell you about it.
Well, the point of the script, Jack, is so you stay on it so you don't go over our time. East Metro Tea Party meets at the Machine Shed Lake Elmo. We have a good time. We're not of all of Jack Rogers' age group. We have younger people. And I'm not going to take any more time because I already got the cue to give the microphone back. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
If you ever want to kill a couple hours, ask Jack Rogers about the North Metro Tea Party Patriots. Our next speaker is Bart Armstrong with the Jonah Prophecy. Bart?
Hello. The diabolical plot quashed our rugged individualism and replaced it with dependency on government. They try to extinguish our self-reliant spirit. This tactic has eroded a preordained structure called the family. We need smaller government and fewer taxes. The Jonah Prophecy is leading the charge to restore our nation to the values upon which it was founded.
Well said. Next, from the Minnesota Tea Party, Randy Lebo.
Randy.
Randy.
Tight schedule. Hello, my name is Randy Lebo, and I'm with the State Tea Party Organization in Minnesota. I want to invite you to come to a Tea Party meeting. There's now about 54 Tea Parties in the state of Minnesota. They're located all over the place. If you go to the Tea Party website, you can find where one close to you is. There's 8 in the metro area now, and we're growing still, and I just want to invite you. We also have a table at the very back where we're selling a few things. If you want to come down and see that, we've got information about different Tea Parties there, or I can help you find a Tea Party near you. Please come to a Tea Party meeting. We need to rebuild this organization quickly. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Phil. Phil Cranky.
He's on the phone.
I tell more jokes, but... Ready to go?
All right, everybody, thank you so much.
That's why it's a two-man show.
This morning. He teases me. We want to thank you for coming this morning. It's been absolutely glorious. We're so happy. So many of you, I mean, look at you, have come out to not do chores around the house, but to fight for your right to not get taxed a lot. I could
do something. And to party, because literally, the DFL wants to tax parties. Drinking, smoking.
The keg tax.
We're literally fighting for your right to party.
The beer barrel tax.
Where's the keg?
Where is the keg? Good question.
O'Gara's after the show, Laura Gatz's Red, Right, and Brew. As soon as we're done with this, head over to O'Gara's, 2 o'clock, and the party is there. I'd like to remind folks that the Late Debate is on Monday through Friday, 8 to 10 on AM 1130, right after Jason Lewis.
We want to thank you all for coming out, and now the man who organized all this, the president of the Taxpayers League of Minnesota, Mr. Phil Cranky.
Before you start, Phil, Phil asked us to find somebody to sing the national anthem, and I said, no, Phil, electric guitar. Todd Bordewick, you're not ready yet, but I just want to make sure I introduce you while I can, with the band Chrome Lotus will be playing that, so enjoy that. And now Phil Cranky.
Thank you, everybody. Appreciate you being here. Everybody feeling undertaxed?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, good. Because in about 2 weeks, the people behind us here at the state capitol are going to raise taxes on everybody, everyone, every smoker, every beer drinker, everyone who buys clothing, everyone who pays income taxes. These folks are going to make sure that you're going to pay a little bit more. That's why we're here today. Appreciate you coming out. So let's get the program started. I'd like to welcome our GOP State Secretary Chris Fields, who's going to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Hoorah! You guys ready? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I want everybody to thank Chris again, because one of our U.S. Marines who's served our country very proudly for a couple of decades. So thank you, Chris. Thank you for your service. Thank you for heading up the GOP. Now, Mr. Gary Borgendale to lead us with the invocation.
When I talked with Phil this week, it was like, praise God for this day that was coming, and praise the Lord for this beautiful day. Before we pray, I want to share a few quotes from American history. The first day of prayer was declared by the Continental Congress in 1775. I therefore move that henceforth prayers imploring the assistance of heaven and its blessing on our very deliberations be held in this assembly every morning before we proceed to business, by Benjamin Franklin. The Declaration of Independence has these famous words: "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, among them are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness." President Abraham Lincoln spoke these words in the Gettysburg Address: "That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that the government of the people, by the people, and for the people shall not perish from the earth." Amen. Lastly, these quotes from one of the greatest presidents of America, Ronald Reagan: "We believe that faith and freedom must be our guiding stars, for they show us truth, they make us brave, give us hope, and leave us wiser than we were. If we ever forget that we are a nation, one nation under God, we will be a nation gone under. Without God, democracy will not and cannot long endure." Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the mercies and blessings you have placed upon this state and this nation. Lord, we extend our prayers to those and the families of those who were killed and injured in the recent bombing in Boston. We thank you for the freedoms we have and the protection provided by our men and women serving in the military. Wherever they are in the world, may you continue to provide for their protection and safety. We thank you all for those who served in the Army, the Marines, the Navy, the Coast Guard, the Air Force, and those who are serving in the Minnesota National Guard. We also pray for the families of the military and recognize their service to our country and state. Today we are exercising the right set forth by our Founding Fathers in Amendment 1 to the U.S. Constitution. Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof, or abridging the freedom of speech or of press, or the right of people to peacefully assemble and to petition the government for redress of grievances. When Jesus was asked, "Is it lawful to pay taxes to Caesar or not?" But Jesus, taking a denarius coin and noting that Caesar's likeness was on it, and said, "Therefore render unto Caesar the things that are Caesar, and to God the things that are God." Yes, Lord, we acknowledge taxes are part of government, that you have ordained government. But Lord, we also know from your word, righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach. A nation without a moral and righteous foundation will not long continue, even the United States. A moral and righteous person governs themselves and their families. Limited government begins with a strong self-government or individual responsibility. Lord, we thank you for these Judeo-Christian principles as part of the foundation of our country. Righteous people need less laws. Guide your legislators and executive servants of all levels of government, from the township boards to city halls to the Minnesota State Capitol and to the U.S. Capitol, as they deal with revenue and spending decisions. May these servants seek your wisdom and guidance and be responsible as prudent stewards. May they give you honor and glory and the praise for the outcome. Lord, I invite your Holy Spirit's presence today and your blessing upon the messages, and ask for your continued protection upon this great state of Minnesota and the United States of America. I pray this in my Lord's name, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Now we'll have the National Anthem. The Tax Cut Guitar.
Yeah.